Hi, Lonnie Mackley here. I just want to talk to you a little bit today about the Christian wilderness, and I want to just encourage people that have been in the Christian wilderness. If you're not sure what that is, no, that's not a Christian camping trip. It's just a process where God has led a lot of Christians into a time of wilderness, just like the Israelites went into the wilderness to prepare to take their promised land in Canaan. God has taken a lot of Christians in this time, and he's just allowed the wilderness to come to them, where he's shut down their life, he's unplugged their normal life, and put them into a time of repentance, of preparation, of purification. It's a very difficult life, just like it was for the Israelites in the wilderness, and it's kind of the worst of times and the best of times, but more worst of times than best of times. But it's a time where you really get to know yourself, where God kind of transforms you more into image and less into your fleshly image. And so when you come out of it, you'll be much more ready to be used as a vessel by God to do something for God, and you'll have his heart shaped in you. And that's one of the things that a lot of people have a problem with, is that they come across all these Christians that are, you know, they say one thing, but they live another, a different life, and it's so hard to believe anything. And they don't love, they're very judgmental and harsh, and so God just wants to transform his people into people that are more like him, so that when people here that are truly in need come in contact with you, that you're somebody that is more like Jesus Christ, that they can really receive Jesus because they see Jesus living through you. So in a nutshell, that's what the wilderness is. And so a lot of Christians have been in the wilderness for many years, some in decades, and we go into it in different times, but a lot of us are beginning to come out of the wilderness and to get ready for the great revival, and that is really our promised land, is the souls of humankind, for God to save them, to empower us with his Holy Spirit, so that the same miracles that Jesus performed, and even greater miracles, would be able to flow through their lives, and to be able to save, heal, and deliver the common person that's in need. And we're coming into times, very difficult times in the world, where people are going to be crying out to God for his help. So God just needs people. He wants to flow through somebody he can trust. And if you had a child and you wanted to like run a company through them or whatever it was, you'd probably want to choose one of your children that had a heart like yours and somebody that you could trust to do your will for that company. Well, God's no different, and he doesn't throw his car keys to the kids, so to speak. So I just want to encourage you today that if you've been in the wilderness, just a few things to just help you as you're kind of ending your wilderness and transitioning into your promised land ministry. Just give you a few tips that might be able to help you right now. One is just to repent fully, to forgive fully. You know, God's done a lot of work with you to set you free from certain things, certain sin addictions, and just to take the extra step to let them go as the Holy Spirit tells you to, and to just trust that as you let go of your idol, that God will step in as the real God to meet that need you were meeting with your idol. And also to forgive fully. There's some people in your past that, you know, maybe you've forgiven a lot, but not fully. You've kind of been hanging on to it a little bit. So forgive fully. If you can't forgive fully, ask God to help you, and he will help you to forgive them no matter how terrible the thing is that they did to you. God can do a miracle in your heart and help you to forgive when you can't forgive yourself. God will make the impossible possible. And so forgive them fully, and forgive yourself fully too, because you know, you've been carrying around a lot of guilt for things that failures. You know, the wilderness looks like it's full of failures, and all of these things are meant to show us the real us so that we can, you know, change. But they look like terrible failures. We have to bear a lot of reproaches in the wilderness, so you look like a big fat failure. And God wants to take the weight of that guilt off of your shoulders, so let him do that. Forgive yourself, and press on. This is a new day, a new beginning for you, and you can't take the past with you where you're going. You can't take your guilt with you where you're going. You can't take your idols with you where you're going. The only thing you can take is Jesus where you're going. So I just want to encourage you that way. Like I said, let go of the past. There's a lot of people from your past you've probably been hanging on to. Ministry from the past, a lot of things that God used to do, you're going to have to be willing to let those things go now and just sit down and wait for God to show you what the new thing is. And for a lot of people that are, you know, overachievers, this can be a hard thing to do. They want to just always be doing something to feel in control and to feel like they're worthful. But right now, the Lord just kind of wants you waiting before him, because He wants to empower you. He wants to give you new things to help people with, but you can't do that if you're too busy to spend time with Him. So spend time with Him. And grab onto the future. You're going to have some new things starting to come into your life soon, new people, new opportunities. Right? But you've got to be willing to grab onto them. The wilderness is full of trial runs where you just rush to be obedient, thinking, oh, I'm finally going to get out of the wilderness. But it ends up just being a trial run that leaves you kind of confused and perplexed sometimes, and really kind of gun-shy, where you don't want to take a step of faith again because you just don't have enough strength left to do another trial run. Well, guess what? Your trial runs are over. The next thing you get is probably going to be the real thing, and you're going to have to be willing to take that step of faith one more time because this will be the real thing. And, you know, the real thing may even look like some of your trial runs. And you may feel really tired right now, used up, broken, whatever it is, but you're just going to have to trust that as you just lift that leg to take that step of faith, that God is going to help you from there. And, you know, He'll be waiting for you on the other side. And like I said, it's time to worship. It's time to praise God, to sit at His feet. And, you know, there's Martha and Mary in the Bible. You know, many of us can do Martha really good where we're busy all the time. We like that. But sitting at Jesus' feet can be a bit of a challenge because we don't feel as in control. But now it's time to sit at Jesus' feet and just to seek Him, to put the finishing touches on some of the things that you haven't quite finished. And like I said, you're going to be getting some new connections, new sources of provision that are going to start popping up. And old sources of provision and old connections may begin to pass away. You know, the manna that the Israelites had in the wilderness, it just stopped coming one day, and some of your financial manna is going to be passing away soon. And try not to freak out or get desperate, or you know, cry out to God, and just understand that as the manna ceases, that something new is going to come for you, and it won't just be survival rations like manna was. It's going to be thriving rations. God wants you to thrive. He wants you to have more than enough to be able to do what He's called you to do. And so that's what's coming to you, is more than enough. But just understand there's a purpose for that more than enough. It's not fun money. Everything that you get, there's going to be a reason for it. Understand, too, that there's going to be restoration of your body, of a lot of things in your life. And so just cooperate with the Holy Spirit. If He tells you to start dieting and exercising to get your body back together, there's healing coming for you. There's deliverance from many evil spirits that have been harassing you in your life. There's a complete restoration coming for you. And I also want to encourage you that some of your relationships that have had to be shelved while you're in the wilderness will start coming back, but probably not until things are more established in your promised land, because God doesn't want them as distractions. So try to be patient if you have to wait a little bit longer to see some of those old relationships come back. It's going to be a time of great harvest, but also a time of persecution. We can see an anti-Christian government beginning to form in the world right now in the different regimes. And so persecution is coming, but persecution can cause people to truly repent. You know, terrible times can cause a need in people to really cry out to God. And so just understand that God can use anything, but it will be a time not just of harvest, of persecution, so get ready for it now. Where there's going to be homes of refuge. Some of that more than enough that I talked to you about, God's going to tell you to use it to build homes of refuge, just like kind of Noah had an ark. These are going to be like land arks for people to go to when the times really, really get bad. And it's a time to serve God fully, to obey Him fully, and to obey the Holy Spirit fully again. Some of us have gotten a little sloppy at not obeying the Holy Spirit because we've gotten fleshy. We're dry right now. And we just got fed up with some things. So it's a time where you've got to start listening and obeying the direction of the Holy Spirit again like you used to. And just understand that you're not going to have harvest without the Holy Spirit. And so get used to obeying Him again instantly, not arguing with Him or giving Him lip, and because He wants to use you, but you're going to have to be obedient. Take steps of faith just like you used to do. And just remember above all, too, that this is about souls. You were once a lost soul. Well, guess what? There's all kinds of lost souls right outside your door. God wants to reach them. He wants to save, heal, and deliver them with His power. So remember, this is about souls. It's not about anything else but Jesus Christ and saving souls. Okay? Hope this has helped you, my friend. Bye-bye.